All the best, Basil. Boom, boom. Kiss, kiss. There you are, young lady. Ah, the fickle finger of fame, eh, folks? Everybody wants to be a celebrity these days. And as soon as they become famous, they wear dark glasses all the time so as no one will recognise them.
Ta-da!
Who are you?
It's not fair. Where's my 5 minutes of fame? And settle for 5 seconds.
I don't think you'd enjoy fame, Mr. Stephen. I had a friend once who was the toast of the town, but he soon got fed up with it.
Why?
Everyone kept trying to butter him up.
You lot, this is no time to be sitting around reading. We've got a show to do.
Sitting around reading is part of this week's show. It's in the script.
Hmm? Scene two, interior flat. Today, Molly and Dave are reading, etc. All right. Very entertaining.
Hello. This is Hurrah magazine we're talking about, OK?
Dave, surely you're not reading Hurrah.
No, mate. 100 pages. You know, the price of sherbet's gone through the roof. Which may impact on my business plans later this episode.
All my mates from entertainer school have done really well. Look at Robbie Williams. 4-page spread in Hurrah. I was only chatting to Robbie a little while ago.
And what did Robbie Williams possibly have to say to you?
Can I have fries with that?
The telephone. Might be work.
There's always a first time.
Hello?
Who is it?
It's a stranger. Sorry, what did you say your name was again?
Swifty.
Oh, Swifty. I didn't recognise your voice.
It's my agent.
Well, he was right when he said a stranger then.
Yeah, I can tap dance a bit. Accents. I'll do them all. Yes, sir, he sure can. When?
Today.
Okay,
mate, see you soon.
Thanks, Swifty. You bet.
Ciao.
Ciao.
Ciao?
Is showbiz for bye? They're auditioning today.
What for?
Only Cockney Sparrows.
Cockney Sparrows?
Isn't that Telly's top rating soap about rough East End folk what has made superstars of many of its cast? Glad we got that out the way.
It is.
Well, let's go!
Wait for me!
Right, for this week's episode of Cockney Sparrows, I need a fat bloke, a thin bloke, a clown, an old woman. And a voiceover man.
That'll be me. See you next week.
And the rest of you can buzz off.
Never mind. Anyway, the show's awful. Lee, good.
Minute, Mr. Couple. I need a bloke with a wide face and a dog.
Wider, wider.
Move, move.
You'll do. You and you.
Yes. Big script, Stephen. Got lots to learn.
Quite a lot.
6 to be precise.
6 episodes? Blimey.
No.
6 scenes?
Not quite.
You only got 6 lines.
No, don't be silly. Ha, ha, ha.
6 words. He's only got 6 words and 2 of those are I.
Well, I got 4 more than you. You only got 2 words and both of those are worth...
Catu.
Listen, do you want me to go over your line with you?
Come on, Molly, would you? Would you really?
Really?
Yeah, I suppose. So... what's the scene about?
Picture it in your mind's eye. It is evening. A blood-red sun is setting over the King Richard pub. And the rates of pink evening mist lick across the Verdant car park.
Paul, do get on with it.
OK.
They've all just been to the funeral of old Nelly, who ran the fish stall.
Oh, no, she dies.
Molly, 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 Molly. She wasn't real. She was just a two-dimensional character in a TV show. Yeah.
That's rich coming from him.
Anyway, everyone's gathered in the pub, the King Richard for the wake. Now, Mrs. String from the Laundrette is offering a plate of sandwiches around, and she comes to my character.
Man in cap.
Man in cap. And offers him a sandwich.
So you... Sorry. Man in cap says?
So I say. I don't mind if I do.
And I, playing the dog, say, woof, woof.
And that's it.
That's it. But how do I say it? Loud! Quiet, with barely suppressed emotion. It's a great strain for an artiste of my calibre. I don't mind if I do, Pet. I don't mind if I do. I don't mind if I do. I'm ever so nervous, Basil.
Don't worry, chum. I used to suffer terribly from stage fright, but I found a fantastic cure.
Yeah?
I used to take a 20-minute walk 3 minutes before I went on.
Hi, I'm Dominic. I'm the, like, director. You must be man in cap.
Hi. He looks so young.
Don't worry. He'll grow out of it.
OK, so in this scene, Mrs. String, Ethel here, offers you a sandwich and you say...
I don't mind if I do.
Great. Spot on. OK, shall we try one? Mm. Everybody happy?
Yes!
OK, it's after the funeral and everybody very sad.
Oh. I wish he'd make his flipping mind up.
And action!
It's how Nelly would have wanted you to go. Down a fish stall with a nice plate of jellied eels and a cup of rosy lee. But I warned her against them eel bones. Oh... Sandwich.
Oh, now what was the line again? Yes, please. No, that wasn't it. Oh, that reminds me. I must nip into the supermarket on the way home. We need milk. Hasn't the price of butter gone up?
I don't mind if I do.
Woof, woof.
Very good, Ethel. Lovely. Now, man in cap, I like the way your grief is really coming through.
You do?
And maybe you could come in just a little bit quicker with the line.
Sometime this week would be great, mate.
Action!
I don't mind if I did...
Cut! Cut, cut, cut! That was... Oh, what's the word?
Well, bloomin' and brilliant don't exactly spring to mind.
That was it. Brilliant.
Me? I didn't mean that he was...
Brilliant! Such emotion, such depth. The fantastic, quirky character you brought out in the line, the strange body language you portrayed.
I did.
He did?
You did. Wasn't he brilliant, everyone?
Wow.
Okay. Stephen, you take a well-earned rest. We'll do the close-up on the dog.
Ready when you are, Mr. Spielberg. Oh, my big moment here. Lights, camera, action.
Can someone take him out of that silly suit so he looks more like a Jack Russell?
What? I don't act naked unless the park calls for it. No, I refuse. Get your hands off. Now catch me dead. You've done that before. Oh, let's watch the other side.
Shh, Basil, it's on.
It's how Nelly would have wanted to go. Blah, blah, blah. But I warned her about them eel's bones. A sandwich.
And I'm out of ado! Good, eh?
Yeah. Catchy.
Yeah, brew.
Hello. Oh, hi, Mum. Yeah, good, wasn't it?
All right, then. I don't mind if I do!
Oh, dear.
Ah, good old Mum. She knows talent when she sees it.
Has she tried contact lenses?
Hello? It is he. Oh, Swifty! Oh, it's really good of you to call.
I've got a load of things lined up for you.
You did?
You're going to be a really big star.
Really?
You're fantastic.
Oh, that's great.
OK,
thanks, easy. I don't mind if I do!
Ciao.
That was my agent. He loved it. He's putting me up for all kinds of shows. He thinks I'm going to be a huge star.
And so Stephen, propelled by his catchphrase, begins his rapid rise on the rocky road to fame like many a handsome young star before him.
Fasten your seat belts.
I think we're in for a bumpy ride.
He becomes the darling of the daytime chat show.
I don't mind if I do!
And sure as night follows day, the awards are not far behind.
I'd just like to say...
And the telephone never stops ringing.
Supermarket opening on Wednesday.
Can do.
Sun cream advert with Liz Hurley. Let me think about that one. Okay. What? Release a hit record? Well,
I don't mind if I do.
Those pepperoni constantly hounding me. Vultures. Hi, guys.
Oh, dear. Look at him. I feel responsible for setting him off on the path to being such a prized person.
Here, cappuccino on the house.
Hey! I don't mind if I do.
I think success has gone to his head.
Not just his head, he's gone to all of him. And it's spilling over the sides and making a nasty mess on the floor.
Hello, little lady. And your friend. Haven't we met?
We're your nephew and niece. You're our uncle. We live in the same flat. Ring any bells?
No.
Oh, shh.
Hello?
Hurrah!
Hurrah magazine want to take pictures of me in the flat tomorrow.
Wow.
Ciao.
Apparently it's all been arranged. They've done the deal and paid my new manager thousands of pounds up front.
I didn't know you had a new manager.
I don't.
Wait a minute.
Dave.
What? I couldn't resist the Wonga. 30 grand. You could always give it back. I spent it on sweets. £30,000 on sweets? I bought a container load of licorice shetland pants from Poland. Sold them to the local sweet shop for 50.
50,000? That's a handsome profit.
No, 50p. The bottom dropped out the licorice underpant market just at the wrong time. I'd only bought sherbet when it was on the up.
Call me in Hurrah magazine. This is it.
Not quite. You haven't read the small print, Mr. Stephen. Hmm? I'm afraid that it says in the contract that a gorgeous girlfriend is obligatory. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, when was the last time you saw a superstar without a top model on his arm?
It's true. You need a lovely girlfriend, Stephen.
Well, of course I do. But where am I going to get one of those?
Why are you looking at me in that strange way? Oh, no, you don't. No, definitely not. Never. No, 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 no. Which part of no didn't they understand?
Like I said yes to this plan.
Just shut up and smile. We had no choice.
Hello, Stephen, darling. And this must be the lovely...
Basil!
Tiffany Wexford. Hurrah.
Hurrah.
Basil. A lovely name for a lovely lady. Lucky Stephen.
Oh, thanks. She's a real fox.
She certainly is.
You said it, mate.
Now, while my photographer takes some snaps of your lovely family and your delightful home, we'll have a cosy little chat, shall we?
Sure. Cool.
So, when did you two lovebirds meet?
In the cafe.
That's right,
in the cafe.
Wasn't it?
Yeah, that's right. I just finished hosting the best satellite and cable daytime reality makeover awards, and across the room I saw this.
Words can't describe Basil.
They certainly can't.
I can think of one or two.
So you've been together ever since, blah, 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 happily ever after. Lovely.
Ain't it just?
Well, I think that's just about all I need. Except, of course, for the photo of the kiss. Whenever you like.
Saved by the bell.
It's for you, Mr. Big Stuff. Oh,
excuse me one moment, Tiff. Thank you.
Okay, Steve, it's Dominic Man.
Dominic Man?
Cockney Sparrows.
Cocker what? Oh, Dominic! Of course!
Hi!
Listen, I'm just making sure you're okay with that script for tomorrow's episode, yeah? Just says a lot to learn.
Sure. Fine, Dom.
Great. See you tomorrow.
Penny for them, do?
I'm in trouble, Basil. I forgot all about Cockney Sparrows.
Eh?
They're filming tomorrow and I haven't learnt a word of the script!
And it's very thick.
I'm not gonna say it.
Now, about that kiss.
Now,
Now, you promise he's not going to go for anyone.
Don't worry, Dom. I've had me lunch already.
OK. Ready, Stephen? Scene one, take 23. Just try and relax. Do what you did in that first episode. And action.
Excuse me, you want to...
Sorry, Dominic, sorry.
Cut. OK, let's try one more. Take 24 and action.
Excuse me, I want to go!
Sorry, line's gone.
Oh, blimey.
And cut. Tea break, everyone. Except you, Stephen. What's wrong, Stephen?
I don't know. I think it's just the stress of being a celebrity. Maybe I need a rest. I'll be in my trailer.
This is like pulling teeth. What was it he had in that first episode? There was something about him. He was...
Rubbish. And when I say rubbish, I mean absolutely downright talentless and awful...
Eh?
Rubbish. And I owe it to the viewing public to see it. He's rubbish.
You know, I think you're right. He was rubbish. I knew there was something about him, and that thing was...
rubbish!
OK, Dom, I think I'm ready. I know what the problem is. It's...
You're rubbish! And sacked. Bag it up and chuck it out.
Hold on to your hats, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Stephen's fabulous career has gone into nosedive. And it's going to be a crash landing.
And finally, the curtain goes down on sacked soap star Mr. Stephen, who rose to fame as Man in Cap off of Cockney Sparrows. A funeral will be held for Mr. Stephen's career tomorrow. Crowds are not expected.
Troubled ex-soap star's romance a sham. Oh, Basil. I've been exposed.
Really? You've got clothes on in the photograph.
Even hurrah! My exclusive interview with Telly Cheat Stephen by Tiffany Wexford. I'm finished.
You probably don't want to hear this right now. But we prefer you as a failure. Don't we?
Yeah. You were a right plum when you were famous.
Shh, Dave.
No, I'm afraid Master Dave has a point. Fame didn't really suit you, Mr. Stephen. You turned into a media monster. It's better this way.
You know, Basil's right. The one thing I've learnt is that I should be happy with what I've got. Good looks, talent.
Fetch me a bucket, Willie. I think this is going to get sickly.
But most important of all, the best friends a guy could wish for.
Make that two buckets, will you? Oh, well, I'm ready to get the old nut down. Your brush with fame's been rather tiring. You see? Brush with fame, eh?
Yeah.
Why so glum, chum?
Oh, I don't know. I'm feeling a bit down about today's show. I had it all within my grasp and let it slip through my fingers.
Well, butterfingers, that's the will-o'-the-wisp nature of fame.
20 minutes ago, I was a household name. Now I'm not even a name in my own household.
Not true. We all think the world of you. Honest, we really do.
Thanks. Night, Basil.
Good night. What did you say your name was again? Ow!
Boom, boom!
That's showbiz!